And we're back again. So, when we left off, we were checking that our counselors were busy thinking about my laws. Cognatic elective. Oh, I got 10 votes. 10 votes. Kinda need more money. Where am I getting my money anyway? I was gonna check that. Vassals. These guys give me nothing, and that's because they're occupied, and that's a problem. Most of them are counts, aren't they? And oh my, cities bring in the gold, don't they? So I really should build another city in Norland. That would probably increase my income a bit. Pay for itself after, let's say, 7 a year. Yeah, that's the yearly income, isn't it? So after 100 years, it'll pay off. Yeah. No, yearly income 31. So, hang on. My demands gives me a yearly income of 51. City tax 7.2. So yeah, the yearly total is, that's how much it actually gives me. If I ruled it myself, I would be getting 30 something, and it would be modified for my MR. So anyway, after about 50 years, that'll be 300, so 70 years or something, it'll start breaking even. Of course, I've got no trade income because I don't have a... come build some trade posts. Well, building a city here is actually worthwhile. But to do that, I need more money. I'm not exactly rolling in it. Is our king actually going to be able to swing this time? Let's find out. As far as I can tell, the problem is small armies keep spawning up from England and coming over by boat and trying to occupy parts of... Uh-oh, I'm infirm. My body may be sapless and infirm, but my mind is healthy as ever. And then my domestic is too big because my stats start sucking. Ah. This girl, she needs someone to educate her, and that someone might very well be Gabriel. What? She doesn't like me enough. Then I shall send her a gift, and then we shall have her educated. There you go. Because that's kind of important. Can't have Italian countesses running around. Contessas. Countesses? Gladly accept guardianship. Yep, brilliant. So, are you finally gonna die on us, Marcus? With unfulfilled claims. Can I actually manage to get an army out there and press it and win it before he dies? You know what? I'll give it a try. I will give it a try because I really want that title. the duchy. Yep. Let's see. Let's just do it like this. Let's see if we can't. Marsh enough forces to actually do this. You guys can stand down. You guys can merge and get on the boats. The boats. On the boats. One last hurrah, huh? What army? Oh, that one. Send it there. Fief of your own, huh? Nope, you're my spy master, and you're gonna stay my spy master for the foreseeable future. Army Munster, he's out there trying to seriously? My daughter-in-law got involved? Now that's annoying. That is really annoying. Send this home. Let's just hope the rebels don't get involved, because if they do, then I'm screwed. I don't care. Just gonna try to steal one more duchy title before I die. I'm actually kind of excited about this. This is really make or break, isn't it? Infirm Duke Marcus of Dunlag, desperately trying to get a hold one more foothold in Ireland before he pops his cloaks and dies. So let's see if we can do it. That army can't touch me. Slowly sieging them. Better man than Marcus have died young, but he's still holding on, clinging on to life. The old fool, still trying to kill Mayor Alv of Lillehammer. This was an expensive title, let's get it. Audun! Nice to meet you, Audun. And Snøfred. Well, Audun, let's get you a wife. Let's get you a wife. Yeah, this one has potential. Yeah, why not? You do that. And you, Snøfred, you are nothing special, so if the King of the Rus wants to marry her, Gleb. A Holy Roman mastermind theologian. Will you inherit anything? Oh yes, you will. Not sure if inheriting a claim on the Holy Roman Empire will actually be to my advantage. find some good jeans, sir. It's not exactly an abundance of genii or strong, beautiful people lying about in Europe presently, is there? Nope. Can't say there is. Come on. Oh. He's interesting. He's strong. But no. Let's see if we can find someone slightly more useful to us than that. For instance, come again? Of course he is. This guy. Doesn't really help me all that much. Just secures our bonds to them even tighter. Other Norwegian or English dukes. Let's see. What the hell is this army? Can't miss this battle. Okay, this is actually the whole of the British Isles army. More or less. Huh. That's interesting. Let's see. What vassals do you have that I'm not? Duke of Iceland. Do you have any unmarried children? Nope. Duke of Orkney. Everybody's happily married. That's a shame. It's a terrible thing to say. Trondelag, yep. Some random counts. Another random count. Third random count. Oops. Where'd he go? There you go. Fourth random count. Fifth random count. No, there aren't really any good candidates here. How about you? That's your ear, really? What the hell? Okay. I must admit, now I have no idea who. Now you. Stop that. I have no idea who was even trying to get married. Who was I trying to marry off? I'm gonna have to go back and look at this episode again to figure out who I was. It was somebody's twin? This girl. Let's just get her some decent enough fellow. Somebody with a high intrigue that we can get into our court. Wow, you really are a one-trick pony, aren't you? Is that really sort of the only high intrigue people willing to come to my court by marriage? It's disconcerting. Ooh!
Mm.
Yeah, this guy, he'll do nicely. Come on, King of Castile, give me your vassals. Hmm. Yeah, that's not good. It's because my domain size is too big. And that is a problem. So, it's time to get a hold of this and then run off and die. Piety, or no, I'll just talk to the church. I don't really have to keep an eye out on this girl anymore. She's still Italian, but her guardian is a fairly charismatic guy, so he should be able to convert her. Let's hope so. That's an interesting ear.
How on earth did that happen?
Probably has to do with her father, doesn't it? Well, let's hope she stays a genius. Duke Marcus had departed at the age of 73. He died bedridden and infirm. Long live Duke Helga the First. Well, congratulations, Helga. You are my new Duke. So, that marks the end of the reign of Marcus. Fairly successful one, I would say. Let's just make sure I do the things I want to do. Back up to full domain size. Oh, nice, 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 nice. He has ambitions to become a steward. That should probably come to pass at some point. Other than that, a child needs to be educated. I think I'll do that myself. Or maybe I'll just send him off to her. Yes. Successor nomination. Who should I nominate as my heir? The traditional choice would be my eldest son. He does not have the stewardship for it. So Helgi, have you actually managed to breed any genii at all? A daughter, of course. I don't think I will nominate. Yeah, and the Duchy of Trenleg will go to my king unless I get a proper heir in there. This guy is a scheming bastard, isn't he? Elusive shadow. And he wants a title. Who should I nominate as my heir? Fine characters in all the world who are men, who are not in prison, who are my religion, my culture, who are a great house, and sort by dynasty, and let's find the Bergheims. Oh, that's time for a break. So yeah, interesting. point to end the episode, where King Marcus finally died. Did not end the war, as near as I can tell. Let's just make sure of that. Need some more guardians. Again, breeding for a stewardship here whenever we can. Yeah, I can raise him myself, that's fine. He is my son after all. And I am a charismatic negotiator, which will be fine. And my gregarious daughter will be educated by some intrigue. The master intrigue. Yep, there we go. That takes care of that, and I'll be looking for a heir, and I'll be back shortly. So, yeah, cheers.